Hello everyone, what's up? This is Joe Man from the Netherlands. How are you today? Welcome back to my channel. Yeah, I got new gloves, white ones. Want to show you something really different today. It's nothing to do with silver, but it has to do with coins that I started beginning with before silver. And it's one of the reasons why I get into silver. Let me show you. These coins I started collecting. This is an American Eagle, Double Eagle. It's a reproduction made by the Dutch Mint. It's gilded gold. I collected coins because yeah, I saw them on the website and I liked them. So I bought a few coins. I thought, yeah, I like that hobby. Look, this is the Queen Wilhelmina. It's also gilded. Gilded gold. It's 10 guilds. I thought, yeah, these are nice coins. Let's buy these things. But then I looked at the price and I thought, wow, that's really expensive for a little coin. It's a reproduction from Wilhelmina, 10 guilders. This is from 19, let's see, 33. Yeah, 1933. It's all reproduction material, gilded stuff. And I never thought I could buy silver and gold because I thought, oh, these are expensive metals and I never could buy them. So I began buying this kind of stuff. This is a nice one. This is Amalia Catharina. This is the princess from Oranje, Orange. Princess of the Netherlands. It's the first coin they made from her. So I thought that, yeah, that was special. But yeah, it's not pure gold. It's gilded all. It's also gilded. Yeah. Oh, my English is not so good. Sorry. I try my best. Look, this is a stamp. This one is also gilded, not pure gold. In the beginning, I collected stamps, but now I don't anymore because they're not. Yeah, I don't see them as an investment. I bought so many stamps, I had the collection, and they were worth in the catalog for about 2,000 guilders or for 2,000 euros. And then I wanted to sell them, and I couldn't sell them. There was a catalog of 2,000 euro, they say, but I sold them for 200 euros. So it's just what a crazy man want to give for a stamp, you know? It's not worth anything. Just a little paper, little, just like money. So I decided to go to look for another way to make, of to save money. Not to make money, but to save money for the future. And then a friend come to me and he said, why don't you buy silver coins? Why do you buy all this crap? I said, yeah, I don't know. They're not very expensive and special editions, blah, blah. He said, you're crazy, man. These are much too expensive. They're nice, they're beautiful, okay. But they're not worth anything. If you're lucky, maybe a crazy man will give you money for it and he buy it from you, but it's not really worth anything. And except these ones, these are silver, 90%. So he said, yeah, that's collections value. And you have the silver value. So this one is worth something. Oh, this is a nice one. I showed you in another video. But that's it. Yeah, I began thinking. I think, yeah, all right. That's. I need something I want to invest in, and I can store, and I don't want to lose money on it. He said, you have to look to silver coins, gold coins, and they're pure silver. I said, oh, I can't buy them, they're so expensive. But then I looked on the internet and looked around, and I saw, hey, silver is payable. So I began to buy. At that time, we got to buy silver. So that's when I stopped collecting these special coins. Yeah, special. I don't know if they're really special. This is a limited edition. It's from the Liberty of Holland, 75 years Liberty. 1944, 1945, you see. It's very nice. It's gilded with silver plated. But, yeah. It's what a crazy man want to give for it, you know? It's not worth anything. Not real. The metal isn't worth anything. He won't focus. Yeah, it's the same one as this one. Only this one is the background from gold, and this one is silver. So that's just it's the same. It's the same as this one. Yeah, I think it was very special. It's funny, but okay, look, the Bevrijding van Nederland, the liberty of the Netherlands. See a tank there, people, man on the bike. Yeah, I thought it's funny to get these coins. But now I stopped collecting them. That's what I want to show you. And one more thing here, yeah. This is pure gold. I have not a lot of gold. I will show you. I have this one. This is pure gold. I think it weighs beneath a half gram. So it's not really, it's not really much, but I enjoyed it. It's the first gold I ever had in my life, so I was really glad I had something pure. But now I want to show you what else I got, if I can find it. If I can find it. Oh yeah, there he is. So, okay, now you see it, yeah. Queen Maxima, 24 karat gold. Yeah, that was in a time I collected stamps. That's why I bought them. Cost me 50 euros, and this is from Mint Online. It's a site in Holland, and I pay way too much for it. I mean, 50 euros, I got a gram of gold, but this one is less than a half gram. It's so thin. I thought it was nice at the time, so yeah, it's special. Okay, this is one thing I have from gold. Yeah, I'm very proud of it. I have real gold in the house. And this one. The gold bag from Utah. Yeah, people, I got one. Here in the Netherlands, I got my gold bag from Utah. One thousandth of an ounce gold. So, yeah, it's very beautiful. Look at the back side. 24 carats of gold, one thousandth of an ounce. They made this thing so beautiful. Thank you, Utah. Thank you for your gold bag. It's beautiful. So now I have two pieces of gold. It's not much, but I love it. I hope to get some more gold this year, but I want to focus on the silver. And there was last thing I want to show you, what I bought before I got into silver, is this one. I fell in love with this one. 1 kilo copper, 99.9% copper. It's from a Dutch mint. See the this is a windmill, the Dutch. And I gonna open it. I gonna open it, really. Yeah. So get this on the side. Some more little things here. I like that eagle. I want a real one. I heard this one of the most expensive coin in the world. Focus. Yeah. If you had the real one, you're a rich man. But I like the copy of it. That's not a real copy. It's yeah. You call it a copy, but it's real. It's authentic. I have a certificate. So, it's on the side. Look how this looks in real. Look at this. So, oh, look. Wow. Look how shiny that is. Wow. Atom number 29, atom mass 63.546, density 8960 kilogram. Wow, that's a lot of information. I'm not a professor, but it looks cool. Yeah, this is real copper. Wow, nice. Yeah, wow. Look how shiny that one is. I bought this one because it looked like gold. I never can buy a bar of gold like this one. So this one looks a little bit of gold. And I thought, wow, it's so sharp. Sorry, so shiny. It's beautiful. 1 kilo of copper. I won't buy more of these. But there were guys talking about copper and prices rising, and so I saw bullions on copper or rounds, whatever you call it. And I was looking at the rounds, but they were so expensive. You know, a kilo of copper it costs here in Holland 3 or 4 euros. And I bought this way over spot. I bought this one cost me 20 euros to get one bar, but it's beautiful. So I won't buy more. I have now a kilo. I'm satisfied with it. And I think it's beautiful. It's so shiny and it looks like a little gold bar. Yeah. It's beautiful. I think it's pretty, so that's why I bought it. And yeah, now I've got some copper with the collection in the collection. So that's enough. Now I'll focus on my silver. That's more important for me. Maybe in the future a little bit of gold, but the main focus is silver. Lovely, isn't it? So shiny. They did a good job with this. It's echt really, really nice. So that's what I wanted to show you today. I hope you liked it. Please subscribe. Leave a comment if you like. I see you later in the future and hope to show you more. Thank you for watching. Bye.